Hey, really quick before we get started, just sure I'm going to be asked. Just want you guys to know, Liss is back in the start lineup. The reason for the change, the other night against Washington was a team matter, and I'm sorry, you guys, but I'm just not going to discuss team business. So we are moving forward, and we are looking forward to this game tonight against Phoenix and getting back to playing good basketball.
Ever like start questions? Anybody in the room? Pat, want to start? Yep. Go Pat, then Matt.
Kalia obviously is one of the tougher players to defend. You guys did a really nice job against her a couple of weeks ago. What, just in general, do you have to do? She's such a good player in transition to try to keep her from having the big nights that she's had at times this year.
Yeah, no, she's talented. She can get out and run in transition. She's got that length and that speed. We've just got to keep a body in front of her. We've got to keep a body in front of her. We've got to keep from letting her get to the rim on us. That starts for us taking care of the basketball, because that's when she gets a lot of her wide open runs is off turnovers. And so we just have to make sure we do a great job of keeping her body in front of her.
Go Matt, then we'll go Kyle.
Celeste just signed with Phoenix. She's back in the building today. I was just kind of wondering if you had a chance at all to catch up with her today.
I've not seen her. I tried to find her when I heard the news. I'm really excited for her for this opportunity.
Last time you guys played Phoenix, I believe you out-rebounded him by at least 15, probably more, I believe. You've talked about rebounding being a key in general. When you have your bigs involved in particular, like Aaliyah and Nalissa, how important is that for success?
Oh, it's huge. You know, with Brittany Griner out there, she's just, you know, she can get her hands on so many just balls, which causes deflections, which gives them opportunities. And, you know, listen, and AB, they've said from day one they want to be the best rebounding duo, you know, in this league. And so, you know, those guys have a job tonight to do with her. We want to try to keep her as far away from that basket as possible, so it makes it hard for her to get those rebounds.
We'll go Chloe, then we'll go Kelsey. Yeah,
just with Diana Taurasi being out tonight, does that change the game plan at all for you guys?
I mean, Diana is, you know, she's a great player, so it does change, you know, the game plan. But, you know, they've got great players that they've been able to add in and who are stepping up, and, you know, the injury bug has hit them. Hope those players, you know, are back sooner than later. But we just have to do what we do, focus on us and make sure that we are doing our defensive schemes and what the scouting report says.
What have you liked most about Lexi's play over the last two games? She's gotten around 20 minutes, come up big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, Lexi's, she's just so active. She gets she probably averages more deflections on our team, and that's a huge stat that we keep. She's just active, keeps the ball in front, keeps the ball moving. I mean, she's going to go in and get, she might not get the rebound, but she's going to find a way to tip it, and that gives us an opportunity. But, you know, she's just coming in and doing exactly what we need, and appreciate that so much out of her.
Kyle.
Caitlin has a double-double streak going with points and assists, and that was started the last time you guys played Phoenix. What does it say about her game where she is able to score pretty much at will, especially from the perimeter, but also she's able to dish it out like that, and she's already kind of set franchise records?
Yeah, I mean, she's a special player. She is getting her feel of her teammates, and that has a lot to do with her and her double-digit assists for sure. You know, early, you know, we had a lot of missed opportunities that, you know, she probably would have had those earlier, but now that they've played together and they have that chemistry, she's able to, you know, they're making plays now. And she's just a dynamic scorer. I mean, not only, you know, her ability to shoot it, but, you know, she can get to the rim, make those tough shots. She's getting her hands on a lot of rebounds. Just need her to push the basketball, look to attack, and then find her open teammates.
Bria.
Hey, Coach. Real quick, last game, you guys did a great job down the stretch executing. What was something that you personally were telling your team to really rally them, even though they were down but not out?
Yeah, that Washington game was a frustrating game. To do what we did in that fourth quarter, hold them to 13 points, and then for us to score 29. But I also, you know, they had only had 8 turnovers in the first 3 quarters, and then we ended up turning them over 8 times in that fourth quarter. You know, that's just taking it to a different level, and that's all I'm asking these guys to do is carry over from what we finished with in the fourth quarter against Washington and put that together for 4 quarters tonight.
Last one for Chloe.
Yeah, just with Nalissa back in the starting lineup, do you anticipate Katie Lou sliding back to the 3 or putting Lexi in there?
Yeah, Katie Lou, we're back to our starting lineup.
No. Well, that is huge. Honestly, nobody has asked me that yet, so – It's cool. I think obviously Gatorade did a really good, cool job, but like honestly, I can see it from my apartment balcony. So like if I walked out there in the morning, it's just like my face. And it's like quite a ways away, but no, it's super cool. I was like, that probably costs a lot to put that size poster on the JW Marriott. So no, but it's super cool.
And then like you've been on billboards and things like that before and all that for years. I'm sure that a lot of places you go, you'll see your face, kind of like you just said, but is that something you're still getting used to, or are you used to it at this point?
I don't know if I would say I'm used to it. Like, you're driving down the street, and it is kind of like it kind of takes you back for a second. Like, it's super cool, and to be in a city that really supports, you know, the Fever and our whole organization, and obviously the Pacers too. You know, people love it, and that's the coolest part. And then obviously, Gatorade supports women's basketball really well as well. So, the two of those combined, like, it makes for, you know, something special in this city, and people get excited about it, and people will, like, go out there and take pictures and pose in front of it. But I don't know if it's really ever something you kind of get used to, seeing your face that large on a building that large.
Matt.
Yeah, hi, Kaylin. Obviously, last night with the ESPYs, just curious if you were watching it live and what your reactions, thoughts to winning two pretty major awards.
Yeah, I was watching it live. I was just sitting on my couch by myself. I mean, I guess it's pretty cool. I thought something that like really stood out to me was like how much women's basketball was a part of the show. I think it shows where women's basketball is going, and obviously women's athletics in general. Obviously, Serena did a tremendous job hosting, and I think that was great. But to me, like, you know, Juju won, Asia won. I won a couple. I think it just shows the excitement around the game and how many people watched and paid attention and where it's going to go.
Jacob.
Kind of building off the question about the billboard, I mean, dating back to your time at Iowa, what's kind of the process been like for you just almost learning to exist with so many eyes on you, both on the court and off of it?
Yeah, it's definitely difficult. Like, I mean, it's not anything like I would ever want to change. You know, it's something that's super special. And to me, like, I still feel like a normal person. I try to go about my daily life the best I can. But at times, like, there's just things that I can't do that maybe somebody else could. But it's, for me, like, it's cool to see the excitement in our community of how many people support us. And not only here in Indianapolis, but when we're on the road too, like, the fans are great, I'm out to dinner with some of my teammates, whether we're going to the game. So I think that's just something that you have to adjust and plan for and get used to. And just to see how it's evolved from my, you know, career at Iowa, I feel like just yesterday I was a freshman there playing in front of, you know, nobody during COVID. And then, you know, even the year after that, like, our arena wasn't sold out every single game. Like, it was, like, half full. And by the time I was a senior, it was a really hard ticket to get. And now it's obviously the same here as a professional. And I don't know. I mean, I still feel like a young kid that just loves basketball and loves the game and loves being around people and my teammates and my friends and family. And that's how I try to go about my life, honestly.
Pat.
I know a lot of this is your teammates just making shots, but you have four straight games with double-digit assists. Is there anything that you're seeing that's kind of opening up that area of your game?
I think just, like, the comfortability of, you know, kind of starting to find my flow. I think as a unit, we're starting to play faster. I think a lot of times when we're scoring in transition, at times it's coming off of made baskets on the other team. Like, we're getting the ball out faster. We're pushing in transition faster. That's where we're kind of finding a lot of success. But I think just my comfortability of, you know, playing with my teammates, playing in this league, like, I'm just learning every single day. And you know, that's the best for me. Like, just experience. The more experience I'm going to get, the better I'm going to get, the more I'm going to be able to improve and just learn things, from game to game. So I think it's more so just that.
Go, Bria, then Chloe.
Hey, Caitlin. So one thing about Indiana, we're big on the basketball world. Mm-hmm. Everywhere else, so what we like to say, everywhere else is just basketball. Mm-hmm. Do you get that feel here, or is that just all talk?
No, I think Indiana certainly loves basketball, and I could have even told you that during, like, my college days. Like, when we would go on the road, most places, like, it would be mostly Iowa fans, even if we're on the road. No, not when you come play in Indiana. Like, that place is, Assembly Hall is rocking. Like, you can't hear anything. Like, that's a true road environment for women's basketball, and the way they support there is pretty incredible, and they love their Hoosiers. It was like definitely the hardest place to play throughout my college career. Weren't many Iowa fans when we went on the road there. So I think that was my first glimpse of, you know, understanding how important basketball is in this state. And then obviously the history. And then, you know, obviously our franchise, the Fever, like, we've won championships. And what Tamika did was absolutely incredible. And obviously the Pacers too. They've been, obviously this year, they've they were incredible. And just coming to their games, like, you can see the buzz and the excitement, and you see the buzz and excitement just when you're on the streets. Like, people just love it and support it. And for me, like, I couldn't imagine a better place to, you know, start my career.
Chloe, last one.
Yeah, you mentioned how well women's sports were represented at the ESPYs. Just mm-hmm. What did it mean for you to be the first woman to win best record-breaking moment?
Yeah, I didn't know that until my little brother sent it to me this morning. I think it's super cool. I think it probably shouldn't have been the first woman to ever win that award in my eyes, just because, you know, I grew up supporting so many different, you know, female athletes that I idolized and I loved, and the amount of records that I've saw people break and win. Like, to me, like, how did Serena Williams never win that award? Like, that's crazy. Like, just thinking about things like that. But, I mean, hopefully it's the start to, you know, women getting more recognition and, you know, their accomplishments being recognized a little bit more. But obviously it's cool. But yeah, I think it's not something you would have guessed, honestly. But for me, it's just something I'm really grateful for.
All right. Thank you, everybody. Thanks.